Thank you very much. My talk is about the 2019 badge challenge. And there are inevitably going to be spoilers, so I'm sorry if you didn't want that. First of all, I'm going to just quickly introduce myself. I'll try to keep it fairly quick. My name is Carl Sundvall. On the internet, I go by the username Didan. I mostly do programming, but I have interests in a lot of other stuff. I'm a member of the CTF team, whatever. So on to the actual badge. So I actually have the 2019 badge here. So when you entered the conference during 2019, you were presented with this badge. And on the back side were some cryptic puzzle, which is displayed on the screen. You see on the puzzle a bunch of characters with seemingly random rotations. And if we only focus on the characters and read it out like this and ignore the rotations, you get a quote from the movie Hackers, a small text about how you can win 2 tickets, and some cryptic text at the end, which sort of looks like hexadecimal, but if you try to decode it as ASCII, you're not going to have much luck. And we'll get back to that later, but for now we're going to focus on those rotations that we just ignored, because those are very relevant here. So there seems to be a bit of issue. You can think of this, we're going to assume that there is useful data encoded in these rotations. So you can sort of see these as base 4 encoded data. And if we just try to interpret this as ASCII, for example, the easiest way to do this is to first convert it to binary. And if we try to convert each rotation to binary or 2 bits, there are 24 different ways to do this. So there is some form of trial and error involved in this. But if you're lucky, or if you try all of them, you will eventually find this substitution, which turns out to translate to something readable in ASCII. And it contains this text and a link to a site which presents you to this image. Now, if you look at the source of the site a bit more carefully, you will also find an alt tag on the HTML element. And if you take the hint from the image with the chessboard and combine it and think a bit, you might, if you're familiar with chess, you might recognize this string as the encoding for a chessboard. So you can actually translate this to a full chessboard. And now, conveniently, a chessboard is 8 tiles wide and 8 tiles tall. So you might think this is convenient for ASCII. But if we try to decode it right now, we're not going to have much luck. It's just going to be gibberish. But if we look back at this hexadecimal, which we now might realize is not hexadecimal, we can see that it's always a letter and a number. So we can interpret this as positions on the board. So if we look at the first, I don't know what to call it, piece, we see that it's an empty tile. So we might try to, for example, place a piece there and do that for the next two. But then we encounter a tile which already has a piece. And we might want to try to ignore it, or in this case, we're going to toggle it instead. HTML is a bit fucky. So if we instead toggle it, so if it's empty, we place a tile, and if it already contains a piece, we remove it. If we do this for the whole board, we're eventually going to get this board. And now, if we try to interpret it as ASCII, I'm sorry about the issues, we actually get something readable. And if we do it from the bottom up, we're actually going to get something which looks very much like the solution. Come on. I'm very sorry about the issues. Now, with hindsight, we can look back at this image And if we only look at every other row, we see that the image actually explains exactly what we're supposed to do. Exclusive or the games, every square is a bit, lines are hidden letters. With hindsight, this is very easy to see, but it's hard when you don't know this. And another thing, the secti site, you might notice if you ignore certain characters from the URL, if you, for example, type slash A, it's going to autocomplete to about when you, it's going to redirect you. And that's kind of weird. Most sites don't do that. And that made me realize that the secti site is a WordPress site. So afterwards, I realized that you actually can skip the whole rotation step by using the WordPress API and finding all sites, including the hidden ones, the one we just looked at. It doesn't help that much. You still have to solve the chess part, but it's probably a thing you might want to fix next time. But yeah. So I think that's about it. Thank you very much.